Hey there, baseball fans. It's Ben, and I'm here today opening packs of 1992 Fleer Ultra baseball cards. This is Series 2. This is the second year from Fleer Ultra, and this is the first year they have the full high-gloss UV coating, the full bleed on the edges, and the gold foil stamping on every card. So this is a pretty good set. This is really the year that people got excited about Fleer Ultra as a premium offering. This is Series 2, so it doesn't have any of the Tony Gwynn inserts or anything like that, but it does have All-Stars. All-Stars insert set and All-Rookie insert set. In the All-Star insert set, there's a Ryan Sandberg, and that's the one I'm really looking for. See if I can pull that one out of here. I'd love to have another one of those in my collection. So, let's see what we can find. Just really good photography. Look how crisp and clear all these images are. Printing is really good. These actually must have been stored well because they're not sticking together. And I love how they designated rookies on here with the little flag up there. And that was a bust of a pack, but I'll show you the backs too. Computer generated graphics on the back. Multiple color images. So nice set all the way around. Just nothing of interest in that pack. Let's see if we can find something better out of this one. Series 1 I think is actually better here. The better inserts, those Tony Gwynns and possible autograph, plus some, I think some record breakers or something like that. So I haven't even said a name yet because I found nothing of any interest whatsoever in here. There's Wade Boggs, I'll take that one. Even if he does have his very early 90s shades on. So that's a nice card of Wade Boggs. We'll put him aside. John Smiley with a full-on long hair flowing in the wind. And Ben McDonald. This was a good card back in the day. Doesn't seem to be of much interest at the moment, though. All right. So far, we are kind of... I'll give that Wade Boggs a point, but 1 point out of two packs is not a great hit rate. So hopefully things start to pick up here. Got a number of... these are all the Fleer 1992 Fleer Ultra packs I have at the moment, but I've got some other seasons. There's Andre Dawson, looking good there. So look at that. He always looks so angry. I do have an Andre Dawson autograph too. I got to go to a card show and, you know, pay 20 bucks or something like that and go up and meet him and get him to sign my card. So I still have that. Had him sign a 1983 Topps All-Star card, which is what I had at the time. So maybe someday I'll pull that out and show you guys too. These are sticking together a little bit, not too bad. So only one decent card out of there, Andre Dawson. So again, really bad hit rate so far. I'm not even finding people that I'm like, oh, whatever happened to that guy? There is just not that much interesting that we've seen so far. Let's turn this around right here. So far, still striking out. Man, this is really bad. You know, if you're a kid and you get one of these premium packs with, you know, 14 fancy cards in there, and you probably paid $1.50, which is a lot back in 1992 for a kid. Oh, there we go. Finally, get an insert, but you'd be pretty disappointed with what we got so far. It's Danny Tartable. That's something. John Franco. And there's Deion Sanders. There you go. Not the world's greatest baseball player, but good enough to be in the bigs for as long as he was. And obviously a great football player. And here's one of those All-Star inserts I talked about before. We've got Roberto Alomar, Hall of Famer. These are pretty much 1 in 6, I think, is the probability of pulling one of those. So I had 6 packs, pulled one. Holds true. Nice work, odds makers. Our last one. All right, let's hope we can get something, anything out of this. Eric Davis. Kurt Schilling, Who knows? Maybe he'll be a Hall of Famer this year. Maybe not. And that's it. You know, folks, you win some, you lose some. We definitely lost this one. Out of six packs, four cards of any interest at all, and a bunch of junk wax. I don't even know what to say about it. I'm just going to move on, and we'll see you next time.